the Boston Celtics. After trading Gordon Hayward, they now have a $28.5 million trade exception, which means they could trade for any player that has a $28 million per year contract or even less than that. And the question is, who do you think that the Celtics should target to get over the hump and be championship favorites? Or do they need to target anybody? What do you think?
I think what what their downfall has been the last couple years has been Giannis last year, Bam. Well, sorry, Giannis 2 years ago, Bam last year. So the constant would be they need a big that's bigger than Daniel Tice that can rebound and defend and also be a threat on the offensive end. And I think that should be their go-to right now, to get a big that can essentially help them stop Giannis or contain Bam in that situation, because that's been their lacking. They have the wings. They have the guard play. They just haven't had that consistent big. And I think Tristan Thompson, he was a good, like, Band-Aid. I think he's going to rebound for them. He's going to be a good defender. But I feel like they still need that all-star type big that can really change the East up and give damage to Bam and Giannis for them to really get over the hump.
I agree. I have two names. The first one is, like I told you before, a team that I was going to talk about again in the episode, Rudy Gobert. You don't know what the chemistry is like after what happened last year with the Jazz, and if they're looking to move him, it would be the perfect move. He would fit into the exception, and you know he's the best defensive big man in the league, or at least close to it. He's a defensive player of the year candidate every year, and automatically he would improve their team so much on the defensive end. And he's not a liability offensively. He's not great offensively, but he's solid offensively, especially with the team they would surround him with. But I think that's a little bit more of a you know, fantasy land proposal, because I don't think the Jazz are going to end up moving him. The other more realistic option, and I think that this would be a perfect move for both sides, John Collins. He's not the interior defender that Rudy Gobert is, but he improved a lot last year as an interior defender. And you're talking about a Hawks team that just drafted Onyeka Okongwu. They just signed Danilo Gallinari to a huge contract and Bogdanovich to a huge, a fairly big contract. And John Collins is due for an extension after this year. And supposedly there has not been any progression in their talks in that contract extension. So if they're going to move him, why not at least get something back? Or if they're going to lose him this offseason, why not at least get something back in this package? You know, when you really can afford to lose him at that position, they have great depth down low. And you're talking about a guy on the Celtics side who last year averaged about 21.5, 10 rebounds a game, shot 58%, and shot 40% from three. He can stretch the floor, and they can still play that five-out system, and he's a solid interior defender, would clog up that paint a little bit more and give you a more reliable big man option.
I don't think the Celtics should make a move. I think if they get desperate, then possibly they could. But right now, when I look at their roster, they're about 10 guys deep, like 10 to 12 guys deep. Like
you spread a lot.
But they have Jaylen Brown, that's one, Jason Tatum, Kemba, Marcus Smart, Jeff Teague coming off the bench, Daniel Tice, Tristan Thompson, the combination of Grant / Robert Williams, that's nine people right there. The rookie Aaron Nesmith, is he going to play? That's 10. Payton Pritchard, Carson Edwards. Like, they got some guys. Like, right now, is John Collins an upgrade? Yeah, but now you got to pay him long term, and I don't think he's a good defender. So is he going to really elevate the Celtics ceiling? I don't really see that. And like a guy that I would get that doesn't even cost $28 million would probably be a PJ Tucker, because they need more guys like that need to do the dirty work. They need to dive for the loose basketballs on the ground. They need more guys to shoot corner 3-point shots. They need guys who are going to be the heart and soul. PJ Tucker would be a perfect fit in Boston. I mean, Boston's logo is like what? That's a Celtic, right? Or a four-leaf clover, whatever it is. It's not three-leaf clover. you look at PJ Tucker. He's that guy who brings in that four-leaf clover personality. PJ Tucker brings in that four-leaf clover personality. He's good luck. He's one of the flyest players in the league. He's one of the best three-point shooters. He's one of the best three-point shooters in the NBA. PJ Tucker changes the culture of a team. And he can go to Boston, and he can change their culture. And they can become favorites if they land a guy like PJ Tucker. If you have a lineup of PJ Tucker and Marcus Smart on the floor together, I think that's one of the most unstoppable defensive lineups that's in NBA this season and in the last 10 years in the NBA.
That was beautifully said, but it was a super stretch. PJ Tucker does not change the culture. He's not good luck. What has he done for the Rockets the past two, three years?
He's old troll. He has to be.
Like, I like PJ Tucker. It would be a solid addition for them, but I think they could do better with that trade.
If they do, if they have a lineup out there of Kemba, Marcus Smart, Jaylen Brown, Jason Tatum, and PJ Tucker,
he can't play the five.
He can play the five. What do you mean? He's shown he can play the five.
He can play the playoffs last year.
He can play the. Who got booted in the playoffs?
He got bullied. AD put in the playoffs. AD destroyed.
Anthony is going to be one of the best players ever.
And that's who they have to plan for, because that's who you have to get through to win a championship. And I'm imagining the Celtics.
You don't have to get through him. Wait, who do you have to get through? Do you have to get through?
You have to get through. You have to get through Giannis.
Let's talk about. Let's talk about the East.
Bam is going to get every rebound.
You have to get through 6'11 unicorn Giannis.
What about Tristan Thompson?
You have to get through Bam.
Tristan Thompson.
You can't start Tristan Thompson and PJ Tucker.
You could put PJ Tucker at the four.
Okay, so who's going to start at the 1, 2, 3? You're going to leave Marcus Smart out the game?
Marcus Smart, Jason Tatum, Jaylen Brown.
So where's Kemba? What's wrong with you?
Put him on the bench. Yeah, you can't play defense.
Yeah, that's not
if you have this, Jaylen Brown locks up. Marcus Smart locks up. PJ locks up. Tristan is pretty good defender.
PJ scores Jason 8 points Tatum a game, is good defender. He can only score in the corner.
They're not.
That's
they're
all
not
they need
putting,
him for. They got Jason Tatum and ice.
And Marcus Smart at the one.
I'm just saying, I think PJ Tucker is a better fit. John Collins, in the modern NBA, you need guys who can switch. John Collins can't switch onto perimeter players. Like, he can't. PJ Tucker can.
For the Celtics right now, with their personnel, they need somebody who can guard the five. And that is what John Collins does better than PJ Tucker.
He's not better than Tristan Thompson.
Can I say
at
something?
Doing that.
Can I say something, guys? That was the worst take I've ever heard.
Except
you say in my
Tristan
life.
Thompson is not that good of a player at this point in his career. Maybe if you're
talking
about.
He's a way better defender than John Collins. It's not close. It's really not close.
He's maybe a better defender than John Collins, but John Collins is world's better offense.
Okay, what do the Celtics need?
The Celtics don't need another guy who gets the ball. But they don't need a 6'5 big man.
They have three.
They need a defensive.
PJ can play the four or three. Come
on, I agree.
No, they don't need him to play the three. They have Jaylen Brown.
If you have him off the bench, that's a huge addition. I think that's a huge addition to their team.
Okay, yeah, off the
bench. He doesn't even have to start. He can come off the bench.
Okay, no. Off the bench, okay, yeah, that's cool. But they don't. They have a Grant Williams who's probably going to be better than PJ Tucker.
He's not better than PJ Tucker.
No, I didn't say he is.
He can't even shoot.
He's going to be better than PJ Tucker.
Come on, man. That's a
PJ couldn't shoot until he was 31.
They don't need to trade for a bench guy, though. They're not looking for a bench
guy. They need a star.
They need an interior player.
I mean, I think a better option than John Collins would be Aaron Gordon. I think he can switch better off on players.
That's another
he's
wing,
not a good
though.
Defender.
He's a
and
four,
he's
though.
Not as good offensively as
if
John
you
Collins.
Think Aaron Gordon is not a good defender, then John Collins is not
is,
even the vicinity of being
not,
out.
He
you
is play not Aaron as Gordon good a defender five? As John Collins.
You don't... You, what?
I do not think...
You gotta
I
watch
do not
Hawks
think,
games. No, John, I'm telling
John Collins
you, John's
I do watch Hawks games.
No, I watch every Hawks. I'm telling you, John Collins is horrible.
Okay.
No, he's really bad. Like, no, he's bad. Like, he's bad, bro. Like, it's like, I get it, though, but they don't need that either. They don't need another guy because he's a scorer. Like, John Collins is a scorer. They need Rudy Gobert was a good one, but they're probably not going to.
They need a rough rider. That's PJ Tucker.
No.
That's who he is.
They don't need a rough rider.
They don't need anybody
Daniel
coming in there with Houston.
What was Boston's problem in the playoffs? Marcus Smart called it out. We don't have enough guys that are hustling. We don't got enough guys that play with heart. PJ Tucker brings
that's
that heart
so
to the
cliche.
Team. He said that.
But
he said that.
What team in the NBA has more heart than Marcus Smart, Jaylen Brown, Jason Tatum plays hard? Like, they had heart. They also
heart.
Had heart. They also had
you,
a center.
You know what I mean?
I have a question. What about Vucevic?
They had a center that couldn't stay on the court. Daniel Tice was a liability in the playoffs. He cannot play starter minutes in the playoffs.
But
and
you know what
cancer is unplayable.
You know what Marcus Smart is talking about when he talks about heart.
Yes, and he's
you know
wrong.
He's talking about guys like
he's not talking about PJ Tucker.
He's talking about guys like Fred VanVleet
and
I'm guys like
and,
that.
And I'm telling you, he's wrong. That is not what they
not
need.
Wrong.
It's cliche. It's literally
they
went
to the ECF. They don't need that.
It's a hand-fed PR department sentence to the media.
They went to the ECF with no bench.
No.
They got Jeff Teague, who's going to be one of the best backup point guards in the NBA this upcoming season.
Why do we keep saying that?
Because I think he is. Who's a better backup point guard than Jeff Teague?
Dennis Schroeder plays basketball.
He's going to start this year for the Lakers. Starting. Who's starting over
LeBron Dennis Schroeder? LeBron starts at the one. He's a one now.
Okay, but I didn't say the best. I said one of the best.
No, then you said name me a point guard who's better than the backup.
Name me a second one.
No, that's not second. Now,
you can't think of one because Jeff Teague right is that. All right, Jeff Teague is that second guy. Right. That's what I'm saying. That's why I'm saying that you need more guys off the bench. Now they got Jeff Teague. So now they drafted Aaron Nesmith. Get P.J. Tucker, some guy who could play defense. That's what I'm talking about.
They don't need P.J.
Let me tell you what, I don't think it would work because their problems in the ECF was Bam. Bam was literally their problem on defense and offense.
He cannot handle Daniel
Tice. I think Tristan Thompson would do a good job on Bam. We're forgetting that they have Tristan Thompson.
I'm going to say why he can't. Because when they put up in the pick and roll, Tristan Thompson can't go out there and guard anybody on Miami on the perimeter.
And the other thing about Tristan Thompson.
You can't play him
like,
for too long.
If it was 2015,
and Bam can go out there
Tristan
on the perimeter,
Thompson, it would be different. Yeah. But Tristan Thompson presents a similar problem to what Daniel Tice was. Like, he just is so one-dimensional. At this stage, like, he rebounds, and he's a solid interior defender.
That's
he's
all
a,
they need,
He's
though.
A negative
offensive. What if Bam takes him out on the perimeter? What can Tristan Thompson do then?
He's 6'9". He moves pretty good laterally. He can defend some guys, man.
Yeah, you best
Tristan
stop,
Thompson
man.
Is not that bad.
I'm like, he's a Band-Aid. I feel like they need an all-star.
They're not getting an all-star center.
A good call
that they
from
need.
The chat. A good call from the chat. Akil said Vucevic.
I said that.
Vucevic will be perfect.
I said that 5 minutes ago.
You guys looking at it as in, like, through an offensive standpoint.
How about Andre
they
Drummond?
They need defense.
But they also need somebody.
He's a better Tristan Thompson.
They need somebody who can stay on the court offensively, too. Daniel Tice is a fine interior defender, but he was not.
They literally need an Enes Kanter and a Daniel Tice.
Combined.
No, they need a guy who can. They need a guy who's going to shoot threes, who's going to work
his
tail off.
Stand in the corner.
That's P.J. Tucker right there.
They're going to get out rebounded again.
P.J. Tucker, look at me. P.J. Tucker cannot guard Giannis. Cannot guard Bam, cannot guard Anthony Davis.
Neither can John Collins. What are you talking
about?
He can
put up a much better fight than P.J. Tucker.
No, he can't.
A much better fight than P.J. Tucker.
No,
he can't.
Defensively?
I feel like he'll just score more than PJ, but I don't know.
You just really, you said to my face that John Collins would do a better job on Anthony Davis and P.J.
Yes.
Tucker. I think
P.J. Tucker
do you go on 2K and just look at the listed height, and that's how you determine who's going to do a better job? P.J. Tucker is...
Okay, how did it fare in the playoffs last year for the Rockets? Tell me that.
They destroyed him.
But what would have happened What would have happened if John Collins was guarding
Anthony Davis?
Davis
would have destroyed him, too. But like John Collins would have scored.
P.J. Tucker is much stronger than John Collins. That's why he can do better against big guys like that.
I would say this. A lineup of Kemba, Smart, Brown, Tatum, P.J. Tucker would literally lose them. In a playoff series again with Miami, they would lose again. They probably lose to the Bucks, because that's just 6'5" centers are just not it. They need a big that's better than Tristan Thompson. Tristan Thompson is a Band-Aid. The same thing as Daniel Tice. He's a Band-Aid that's gonna get them as far as they can get them. But to get over that hump and to get to that finals, they need a big.
I don't even know if the Celtics right now could get past the Sixers. Who's guarding Joel Embiid? Tristan Thompson?
I think we say this every year about
beaten,
the Sixers.
They beat
the
Sixers and repeatedly.
And
they
the
beat
Sixers,
them 4-1.
The Sixers had health problems last year.
No. Before that, they beat them 4-1.
They beat them without Kyrie, with the rookie Tatum.
They beat Joel Embiid. Well,
and we were asking same question about the center. Who was the starting center that year? I don't even remember.
I don't remember either. Yeah,
had Al Horford. That's the reason the Sixers went out and signed Al Horford.
That's fair. You got it on that.
Whatever. A career game for him is 12 points.
Joel Embiid didn't dominate them last year, though.
Because it was Joel Embiid against
what was
the
Ben
Celtics.
Simmons going to do offensively? Can I ask you that? Like, what was he going
to
do?
Ben Simmons has not changed the look of that offense. He's a better playmaker than anybody else.
He is, but like, he's not going to take away any type of attention towards Joel Embiid.
The Sixers made a lot of moves to get better.
They're dangerous. But I'm saying
let's move on.
Because if they play Embiid right now with that PJ Tucker guy, they're going to get destroyed.
Who?
The Celtics, if the Celtics go get P.J. Tucker and they play Embiid right now, Embiid will average 30
on
them.
You guys are forgetting, it's not just having Tucker. It's having Tucker with the guys they have now.
They have shooters,
Tristan
though.
Thompson.
You're not
going
to be able to double team if you have Ben Simmons out there with Tobias Harris, Seth Curry, and Shake Milton. You can't leave Shake Milton, Seth Curry, or Tobias Harris open.
I think you can sometimes, yeah.
You Seth can Curry sometimes. And Shake are 40%
Seth
three-point
Curry is Shake on Curry very is low volume. Top
five. Yeah, but all he has to do is stand there and be ready.
On very low volume. I don't really trust Shake Milton doing that.
But you trust PJ Tucker shooting threes in a corner.
No, I trust PJ Tucker's heart and his hustle. Oh my, he's a BR Kicks champion. Who on the Sixers is a BR Kicks That's champion? A troll. Nobody's a BR Kicks champion. So he's a champion at something that nobody on the Sixers is a champion of yet. Nobody says he's a champion outside of Thompson.
Next. VR kicking.